Hello viewers, in this video I'll solve the questions on expectation or mean, variance and binomial distribution from the check your progress section of unit 4 probability distribution. The third question, what is the mean of the numbers obtained on throwing a die having written 1 on 3 faces, 2 on 2 faces and 5 on 1 face? Now here it is given, we have to find the mean of numbers which are obtained when we throw a die in which the number 1 is written on 3 faces and 2 on 2 faces and 5 on 1 face. Usually in a die we have 1 written on 1 face, 2 on the other face, 3 on the next face, then 4 on the other face, 5 and 6. But here in this die we have 1 which is written on 3 faces and 2 written on 2 faces and 5 on 1 face. So let us take let the random variable x denote the number obtained. So the various values which x can take are 1, 2 and 5. So here it is given 1 is written on the 3 faces, so the probability of getting a 1, it will be 3 upon 6, or it is equal to half. And then the next number 2, 2 is written on the 2 faces, so probability of getting a 2 is 2 upon 6, it is 1 by 3. And then 5 is written on 1 face, so probability of getting a 5 is 1 by 6. Now we have to find the mean of this. Now we know mean is nothing but it is the expectation of this random variable. So expectation of x is given by summation I is equal to 1 to n xi pi. Or here we have to multiply each of these and add the product. So it is equal to 1 into half plus 2 into 1 by 3 plus 5 into 1 by 6. So 1 into half plus 2 into 1 by 3 plus 5 into 1 by 6. So the LCM is 6. If we simplify, we get numerator is 12, LCM is 6. So this is equal to 2. Therefore, the mean is equal to 2. Next question. Rahim tossed a fair coin 10 times. Find the probability of exactly 6 heads, at least 6 heads and third subdivision at most 6 heads. So here we are given Rahim tossed a fair coin 10 times. Since he is tossing a fair coin, it qualifies as Bernoulli trials. So here we have n is equal to 10. We have to find the probability of exactly 6 heads, at least 6 heads and at most 6 heads. So if we consider the probability of success as getting a head, then p is equal to half. And we know q is equal to 1 minus p. So 1 minus half is again half. Now let us write the general formula. Probability of r successes, it is given by ncr p power r cube power n minus r. Here n is 10, so it is 10 cr, p is half, so half power r, q is also half, so half power 10 minus r, or this is equal to 10 cr half raised to r plus 10 minus r, so it is half raised to 10. Now we will find each of these. The first one is probability of exactly 6 heads. So probability of x equal to 6 is, here in place of r we have to substitute 6. So it is 10c6 half raised to 10. Now 10 c6 is nothing but it is 10 factorial by 6 factorial into 10 minus 6 factorial, which is 4 factorial. Now this 10 factorial, we can write it as 6 factorial into 7 into 8 into 9 into 10. And 4 factorial, we can write it as 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. So 4 twos are 8, this 8 and this 8 will go. Here 3 into 1 by 2 raised to 10. Here this will go into. So when we simplify, we get probability of x is equal to 6 as 105 upon 512. So probability of getting exactly 6 heads is 105 upon 512. Next one, probability of getting at least 6 heads. So the second subdivision, probability of x greater than or equal to 6. So it is equal to 10c6 half raised to 10 plus 10c7 half raised to 10 plus 10c8 half raised to 10, then plus 10c9 half raised to 10 plus 10c10 half raised to 10. So half raised to 10 is common, that can be taken outside. And first we have 10c6, 10c6 is 210, then 10c7, if we simplify we get 120, 10c8 we get 45, then 10c9 is 10 and 10c10 is 1. So if we add all this and simplify, we get 386 upon 2 raised to 10, or it is equal to 193 upon 2 raised to 9, which is 512. Then the last subdivision, probability of at most 6 heads. Probability of at most 6 heads is probability of x less than or equal to 6. Or it is equal to 1 minus probability of x greater than 6. So it is equal to 1 minus probability of x greater than 6 is probability of x is equal to 7, x is equal to 8, x is equal to 9 and x is equal to 10. So from here it will include the sum of all these. So here again half raised to 10 is common, let us take it outside. So inside we have 10c7 plus 10c8 plus 10c9 plus 10c10, or it is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 raised to 10 into, this is 10c7, 10c8, 10c9 and 10c10. So it is 120 plus 45 plus 10 plus 1. So it is 176. Now when we simplify, this is 1 minus 11 by 64, or it is equal to 53 by 64. Next question, find the probability of getting 5 exactly twice in 7 throws of a fair die. Here if we consider the probability of success as probability of getting a 5, then we can consider this as Bernoulli trials, where n is equal to 7, then probability of success, it is given by probability of getting 5, this is equal to p, and probability of getting 5 is 1 by 6. And we know probability of failure q is 1 minus p, so it is 1 minus 1 by 6, which is 5 by 6. And We also know for binomial distribution, probability of r successes, it is given by ncr, then p raised to r, q raised to n minus r. Here probability of getting 5 exactly twice in 7 throws of a fair die, it is nothing but this is equal to probability of ri equal to 2. So this implies probability of ri equal to 2, it is given by 7c2, then 1 by 6 the whole raised to 2 into 5 by 6 the whole raised to 7 minus 2. So here in place of r we are substituting 2, and in place of n we are substituting 7. P we have, it is given as 1 by 6, and q we have calculated as 5 by 6. So when we substitute all these, we will get probability of getting 5 exactly twice in 7 throws of a fair die. So this is equal to 7c2 into 5 raised to 5 upon 6 raised to 7. The next question, let x denote the number of hours a class 12 student studies during a randomly selected school day. The probability that x can take the values xi for an unknown constant k is given here. Probability of x is equal to xi is 0.1 if xi equal to 0, k into xi if xi is equal to 1 or 2, k into 5 minus xi if xi equal to 3 or 4. The first one, find the value of k. The second one, what is the probability that the student studied for at least 2 hours, exactly 2 hours, at most 2 hours. So here it is given x is the random variable which denote the number of hours a class 12 student studies during a randomly selected school day, and it is given by these values. The probability takes these values for each of these xi. Now we have to find k and then probability of each of these. So first let us find value of k. First let us draw the probability distribution table for this. When xi is equal to 0, the probability is 0.1. 0.1 is nothing but it is 1 by 10. Then for xi is equal to 1 or 2, probability is k into xi. So when xi is 1, it is 1 into k, and when xi is 2, it is 2 into k. Then for xi equal to 3 or 4, the probability is k into 5 minus xi. So when xi is 3, it is k into 5 minus 3, 2k. When xi is 4, it is k into 5 minus 4. So it is 1k or k. Now if we consider this as a probability distribution of this random variable x, then the sum of this probability summation pi is equal to 1. So from that we can find the value of k. Since summation pi equal to 1, I is equal to 1 to n. So this implies 0.1 plus k plus 2k plus 2k plus k is equal to 1, or we have 6k is equal to 1 minus 0.1, it is 0.9, or k is equal to, it is 0.9 upon 6, or it is 0.15. So the value of k is 0.15. Now I'll continue in the next page. Now let us find probability that the student studied for at least 2 hours. So B subdivision, probability of x greater than or equal to 2. It is nothing but it is 1 minus probability of x less than 2, or it is 1 minus probability of x is equal to 0 plus probability of x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1, it is k. K we already found it as 0.15. So 0.1 plus 0.15, so it is 1 minus 0.25. So this is equal to 0.75. Then we have to find probability that the student studied exactly 2 hours. So probability of x equal to 2, it is equal to, so for x equal to 2 it is 2k. It is 2k and k we already calculated as 0.15. So it is 2 into 0.15, which is 0.3. Then the next part, probability of at most 2 hours. So probability of x less than or equal to 2. So x less than or equal to 2, it will be probability of 0, xi equal to 0, plus probability of xi equal to 1, plus probability of xi equal to 2. So it is equal to 0.1 plus 3k, or it is equal to 0.1 plus 0.45. So it is equal to 0.55. The next question, how many times must Sumit toss a fair coin so that the probability of getting at least one head is more than 90%? So here, if we consider the probability of success as getting a head in tossing a coin, then we have P is equal to half, then Q is equal to 1 minus P, which is 1 minus half, which is again half. We have to find n, that is the number of times Sumit has to toss a fair coin, so that the probability of getting at least one head is more than 90%. Now we know probability of our successes, it is given by ncr, then p raised to r, q raised to n minus r. Here p is half, so half raised to r, and q is also half, half raised to n minus r. Now this is equal to ncr half raised to n. Now it is, we want to know n for which probability of getting at least one head, that is probability of r greater than or equal to 1. This is more than 90%. 90% means 0.9. Now probability of r greater than or equal to 1, it is nothing but it is 1 minus probability of r less than 1. Probability of r less than 1 is probability of r equal to 0. Now this is what we have to find. We have to find the value of n by substituting 1 minus probability of r equal to 0 is greater than or equal to 0.9. Now probability of r equal to 0 we can substitute here. So this gives 1 minus nc0 half raised to n is greater than or equal to 0.9. Or from this we have here nc0 is 1. So 1 minus 1 by 2 raised to n greater than or equal to 0.9, or 1 minus 0.9, which is 0.1, greater than or equal to 1 by 2 raised to n. Or we can write this as 2 raised to n greater than or equal to 1 by 0.1, so it is 10. Now we know that if we put n is equal to 3, which is 2 cube, we get the value as 8. 8 is not greater than 10. On the other hand, if you put n is equal to 4, then we have 16, which is 2 raised to 4, that is greater than 10. So from this we can see that n is greater than or equal to 4. So if Sumit tosses the coin 4 times or more, then the probability of getting at least one head is more than 90%. So the value of n is more than or equal to 4. Next question, a pair of dice is thrown and the random variable x represents the sum of the numbers that appear on the two dice. Calculate the mathematical expectation of x. So here it is given the random variable x, it represents the sum of numbers which appears on these two dice when we have a pair of dice thrown. We have to find the mathematical expectation of x. Similar problem I have already solved while discussing about probability distribution. There we drew the probability distribution table. Here we are asked to find the mathematical expectation of x. So let us consider the random variable x defined as sum of digits on rolling of two dice. Then the sample space of the experiment, it is represented like this. And if we add the numbers that appear on the die and draw a table, we will get this form of a table. So when the outcome is 1, 1, the sum is 2, outcome is 1, 2, sum is 3, outcome is 1, 3, sum is 4, and so on. So we can see that x can take values from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So these are the values which x can take. And the probability for each outcome is also given here. Probability of x is equal to 2 is, there is only 1, 2. So it is 1 by 36. Then probability of x is equal to 3 is, there are actually two possibilities. So it is 2 by 36 and so on. The same problem up to this I have already discussed in probability distribution. You can check that video. Now we will find the mathematical expectation of x. So here this is xi and this is pi. The expectation of x, it is given by summation xi pi. So it is 2 into 1 by 36 plus 3 into 2 by 36 plus 4 into 3 by 36 plus 5 into 4 by 36. Like that we have to multiply each of these and then add. So if we do that, the LCM is 36. The numerator we have 2 plus 6 plus 12 plus 20 plus 30 plus 42 plus 40 plus 36 plus 30 plus 22 plus 12. So this is what we get if we multiply each of these pair and then add. So when we add all these, we get this is equal to 252 upon 36, or it is equal to 7. So this is the expectation of x. This is the expectation of x. The next question, if the mean and variance of a binomial distribution are 4 by 3 and 8 by 9 respectively, find probability of x is equal to 1. So it is given mean and variance of a binomial distribution are 4 by 3 and 8 by 9. So let us consider a random variable x which follows binomial distribution with parameters n and p. If this is the case, then the mean is given by np and variance is given by npq. So these are the formula for mean and variance if a random variable follows binomial distribution. So here it is given mean is equal to 4 by 3. Here it is given mean is equal to 4 by 3. So NP is equal to 4 by 3 and variance is equal to 8 by 9. NPQ is equal to 8 by 9. So if we divide the second equation by the first equation, we will be able to get Q. So Q is equal to 8 by 9 upon 4 by 3, or it is equal to 8 by 9 into 3 by 4. So it is 2 by 3. So we got Q as 2 by 3. Therefore Q is equal to 2 by 3. From this we can find N and P. P is equal to 1 minus Q. So it is 1 minus 2 by 3, it is 1 by 3. From 1 we can find n. N is equal to 4 by 3 upon p. So it is 4 by 3 upon 1 by 3. So n is equal to 4. Now we can find probability of x equal to 1. The probability is given by ncr p power r cube power n minus r. So here n is 4, so and r is 1, so 4c1, p is 1 by 3 the whole raised to r is 1, q is 2 by 3 the whole raised to n minus r, 4 minus 1. So it is equal to 4c1, 4c1 is 4 into 2 cube upon 81. So this is equal to 32 upon 81. So probability of x is equal to 1 is 32 upon 81. Next question, what is the expected value of number of tails on a throw of a fair coin? Here we have to find the expected value of number of tails on a throw of a fair coin. So let us take, let x be the random variable that denotes number of tails in one throw of a fair coin. Here we have to find the expected value of number of tails on a throw of a fair coin. So here it is one throw. Since it is a fair coin and we have to find the number of tails, if we consider the probability of success as getting a tail, then this experiment qualifies as Bernoulli trial with n is equal to 1, p is equal to probability of getting a tail which is half and q is equal to 1 minus p which is half. So expectation of x, it is nothing but it is np, or it is equal to 1 into half which is 0.5. So the expected value of number of tails on a throw of a fair coin is 0.5. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.